The first lesson is written in the book of Numbers, the 23rd chapter, beginning at the 13th verse. So Balak said to him, "Come with me to another place from which you may see them. You shall see only part of them and shall not see them at all. Then curse them for me from there." So he took him to the field of Zophim, to the top of Pisgah. He built 7 altars and offered a bull and a ram on each altar. Balaam said to Balak, "Stand here beside your burnt offerings while I meet the Lord over there." The Lord met Balaam, put a word into his mouth and said, "Return to Balak and this is what you shall say." When he came to him, he was standing beside his burnt offerings with the officials of Moab. Balak said to him, "What has the Lord said?" Then Balaam uttered his oracle, saying, "Rise, Balak, and hear. Listen to me, O son of Zippor. God is not a human being that he should lie, or a mortal that he should change his mind. Has he promised, and will he not do it? Has he spoken, and will he not fulfill it? See, I received a command to bless. He has blessed, and I cannot revoke it. He has not beheld misfortune in Jacob, nor has he seen trouble in Israel. The Lord their God is with them, acclaimed as a king among them. God, who brings them out of Egypt, is like the horns of a wild ox for them. Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, no divination against Israel. Now it shall be said of Jacob and Israel, see what God has done. Look, a people rising up like a lioness and rousing itself like a lion. It does not lie down until it has eaten the prey and drunk the blood of the slain. Then Balak said to Balaam, do not curse them at all, and do not bless them at all. But Balaam answered Balak, did I not tell you, whatever the Lord says, that is what I must do. So Balak said to Balaam, come now, I will take you to another place. Perhaps it will please God that you may curse them for me from there. So Balak took Balaam to the top of Peor, which overlooks the wasteland. Balaam said to Balak, build me 7 altars here and prepare 7 bulls and 7 rams for me. So Balak did as Balaam had said and offered a bull and a ram on each altar. Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. The second lesson is written in the Gospel according to St. Luke, the 8th chapter, beginning at the 16th verse. No one, after lighting a lamp, hides it under a jar or puts it under a bed, but puts it on a lampstand, so that those who enter may see the light. For nothing is hidden that will not be disclosed, nor is anything secret that will not become known and come to light. Then pay attention to how you listen, for to those who have, more will be given, and from those who do not have, even what they seem to have will be taken away. Then his mother and his brothers came to him, but they could not reach him because of the crowd. And he was told, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside wanting to see you." But he said to them, "My mother and my brothers are those who hear the word of God and do it." One day he got into a boat with his disciples, and he said to them, "Let us go across to the other side of the lake." So they put out, and while they were sailing, he fell asleep. A gale swept down on the lake, and the boat was filling with water, and they were in danger. They went to him and woke him up, shouting, "Master, Master, we are perishing." And he woke up and rebuked the wind and the raging waves. They ceased, and there was a calm. He said to them, "Where is your faith?" They were afraid and amazed, and said to one another, "Who then is this, that he commands even the winds and the water, and they obey him?" Here ends the lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
By thy
Evening is Hilton, Lord, for thy tender mercy's sake. We give thanks for the day that has passed, for the work we have done, for the interactions we have had. We ask your blessing on our families and friends. Grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the church throughout the world. We pray especially for the parishes of which this college is patron and for the life of this chapel. May it serve as a beacon of hope in this community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the world, for peace where there is war, for peace in the Holy Land. Give the leaders of the nations wisdom and justice. We pray for the Queen and her government, for all who make decisions that affect the lives of others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for this college community, for all who lead and guide her life, for the warden and governing body. And we give thanks for all those on whom we depend for our daily needs. We pray especially at this time for all those in the middle of exams, and ask that they may know the comfort and peace of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are in any kind of need at this time. We pray for all those known to us who are struggling with their work or with their mental health. We pray for those who are sick, for those in hospital or waiting for operations. Bless those who care for them, and give all those who suffer strength, healing, and wholeness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remember for good, Lord, those who have died. We pray for the founders and benefactors of this college, for all who have worshipped you here and who now worship you in a greater light, for our own loved ones and friends departed, and for all those who have died in recent days. May all the faithful departed come to share the joy of paradise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless, O Lord, the work of this college, which is named by the name of thy servant John Keble, and grant that love of neighbour and all sound learning may here forever flourish, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Bring you to reign with him in glory, and the blessing of God Almighty,
the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.